You're listening to the Limitless Broadcasting Network.
All it takes is faith and trust. Oh, and something I forgot. Dust. Just a little bit of pixie dust.
Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Pixie Dust Twins podcast. I'm Ashley.
And I'm Sammy.
Please stand clear of the doors. Por favor, manténganse alejado de las puertas.
Shall we begin?
It's time to get things started on the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, validational show.
Welcome, Pixie Dusters. We're your favorite hosts. I'm Sammy.
And I'm Ashley. Welcome to the Pixie Dust Twins podcast featuring Dan.
Hello.
And guest starring Robbie.
I've been on a lot of these lately.
I know, you're just hijacking the show. That's what I told you.
No.
Produced by Limitless Broadcasting.
Don't forget, check out our social media, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, and Facebook.
It's okay. Brett's going to hijack when we do Back to the Future.
That'll be another one I'll jump on.
You're just going to come on all the episodes too. So we're just going to have a new...
We're going to have like five people.
We're just kind of...
five hosts now.
And all the episodes are going to be like an hour and a half long because there's like 100 of us on here. So yeah, it's fine.
Was that how long the last one was?
The Home Alone one was a bit long, if I recall.
But if we recall, we've had long Star Wars episodes where it's just the three of us or two of us.
I still remember that.
Really long.
The Girl Meets World episode we had was the first one that was like
that
2 hours.
Was like 3 seasons.
But I remember that still because it was like 2 hours long and people still listen to it. And I was like, you must really like Girl Meets World because.
Or they just love us.
Maybe.
I'm going to go with loving us.
Okay. That works too.
Let's go with that.
Yeah.
But Pixie Dusters, I know it's the end of January and we're not doing Mighty Ducks anymore. I'm sorry. Blame Disney. They took down the TV show. Mm-hmm. We will be doing the cartoon in the summer. We're waiting for the summer because we're doing a 90s summer with the 90s cartoons.
Mm-hmm.
So we're leaving it for there.
Yep.
But we are starting a new topic, which is Disney dogs.
Disney dogs. Mm-hmm.
I'm so excited for this topic. But this is, Sammy did all the research on these movies. So I am going to leave it up to her to introduce what movie we're starting with.
We're going to start with Homeward Bound, The Incredible Journey from
1993.
93. Oh,
love this movie.
93. I know. It's a long time
ago. Such a good movie.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So, summary, in case you did not know, this movie is about a fun-loving American bulldog pup, a hilarious Himalayan cat, and a wise old golden retriever who embark on a long trek through the rugged wilderness of the Sierra Nevada mountains on a quest to reach home and their beloved owners. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I just pulled some money facts because I was just curious back in the day how much money it made. So the film grossed $41.8 million in the United States and Canada, and it was $15.5 million internationally worldwide. So altogether, it was about $57 million that it made. So much more popular in the U.S. than it was overseas, it looks like. Mm. And our stars, of course, Chance. Is voiced by Michael J. Fox. Iconic.
I didn't know that. Oh,
are you kidding me? That's what I was saying last episode.
I didn't pay attention.
You had no idea that was
Michael J.
Fox.
You didn't know. How do you not recognize his voice?
He has a pretty iconic voice.
He does. Like you could just hear. I can picture him.
It just never dawned on me that it was Michael J. Fox.
That's amazing. To be fair. I didn't learn until yesterday that it was Sally Field who voiced the Sassy. I never knew that.
I didn't know either. And I love Sally Field.
Yeah, I didn't know that either. I'm like, I know this voice. And then I looked it up.
Hear it.
Now I know it. But I'm gonna be honest, I couldn't figure it out.
It's not as recognizable as Michael J. Fox. I mean,
yeah. Right. Michael J. Fox is just being Michael J. Fox as a dog. Yeah.
And the guy that voiced the Golden Retriever was the guy on Harry and the Hendersons.
Yeah, Don Amet. How do you say Amechi? Amesh? Sure. Yeah. Anyway, yes, he was Shadow.
Mm-hmm. When I was younger, I always wanted a Golden Retriever named Shadow. And I still do. But they shed too much.
They do.
I wanted a Golden Retriever and they got me a Cocker Spaniel. Not that I didn't love Mandy, but mm-hmm. I was a little sour.
Spaniels are cute. My aunt had a Spaniel.
Yeah, they are cute.
I mean, they are adorable. I have an English Springer now and she's absolutely adorable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sassy, but adorable.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, so yeah, we already said Sally Field was the cat, Sassy. Mm-hmm. Robert Hayes played Bob Seaver. Kim Grist was Laura Bumford Seaver.
Bumford.
I didn't Brunford. Realize that they,
I'm sorry.
They hyphenated.
Yeah, let me see if I can read this. Now I see what you're saying about it being small and hard to read.
No, right?
I'm going to get my life together. Okay.
Benji?
No, because there's no I at the end. It's just Benj Thali? Thal? Thal? Thong?
That's an interesting name for Peter.
Anyway, he's Peter. Veronica Lauren is Hope. All right. And Kevin, oh goodness. I wish I would have looked at these names ahead of time. Cheval?
Oh, please. We look at names ahead of time sometimes and we still can't pronounce them.
Anyway, Kevin played Jamie, so we're going to go with that. And, okay, I'm sorry. So iconic movie, whatever. I just need to know, I think it's just me, but I really can't stand Jamie in either movie. I just want him to shut up the whole time. Aww. Okay. I just wanted to throw it out there. Okay.
In the second one, yeah. In the first one, he didn't really do much.
He still just, when he talked, I was like, could you just tone it down?
Is that Shadow's owner?
He's the baby, the little kid. Okay. Yeah. Well, I just wanted him to stop talking. I feel bad because he's a kid. I get it. But, no. I couldn't do it.
So I'll tell my theory later. Keep going.
Okay.
I'll tell my theory later. I won't hijack it.
Okay. All right. So I do have like a fair number of facts about this movie. I will not when we get to the next one, just as a heads up. But yeah, but it's a lot of just like how they film stuff. So, I mean, there's not a lot of other trivia for the movie. But unfortunately, this was one of Don, how did we decide to say that? Ameshi's, whatever.
I think it's because I looked him up last night because I wanted to see the face.
The
of
people.
Shadow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure it's Ameshi.
Amishi, okay.
I've seen his face.
So this was one of his final movies before his death, the year of the film's release. So
spoiler alert, he died.
How is it a spoiler? He died in 1993.
I'm just letting you know for those of you guys
who
don't
know. He's not a spoiler.
Know.
He's been dead for like 30 years.
Oh, I know who that is. I know his face.
Yeah. Yeah, you recognize him, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So, although the film is a remake of the 1963 version of The Incredible Journey, which came out, in 1963, it's a Disney movie, too, that Walt produced. And it's also based on a novel by Sheila Burn. Oh, I didn't even realize she had the same last name. I probably should have figured that out. Yeah, as the family. Wow, you can tell I did this last night. So, anyway... the main characters' names and breeds were actually changed. So in the film, as we said, Chance is a young American bulldog. But in the novel, his name is Luth, I believe. We're going to go with that.
Where's and that?
L-U-A-T-H. It's like right in the middle. Luth?
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 Luth.
Luth. We're going to go with Dan Surgeon Luth. And he is a Labrador Retriever. Yeah, we're going to go. Dan is forever the king. So what he says goes. So he says love. All right. Cool. And in the film, obviously, Shadow is a old, wise golden retriever. But in the novel, his name is Bodger?
Bodger.
I don't know where she got these names from. And he is a bull terrier.
No, I don't like it.
That's why I put this in here, because I was like, I don't know how I feel about some of these breeds. And obviously the film has the Himalayan cat named Sassy, but in the novel it's a Siamese cat, it's a male, and his name is Tao.
No.
So there There you go.
I am glad they changed that, because that's all, that's Lady and the Tramp evil vibes. No, no, no.
Yeah,
no,
I no. like the updates.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I like the updates.
I do not like Siamese cats.
I always
put the Lady and the Tramp.
I know, I always put Siamese cats as bad, I think just because of that movie. Yeah, that they are not good cats.
Definitely creepy, but that song gets stuck in your head.
Oh, now it's...
It does it for me. Like,
I can hear it. I can hear it. And it's terrible.
I never even saw Lady and the Tramp. I just looked up that one scene because everybody was talking about it. And I was like, oh, yeah. No, I get
hold up. Hold up.
Wait a second.
What?
You've never seen Lady and the Tramp?
I don't think I have. I've seen bits and pieces of it. I don't think I've.
I don't think I've seen it all the way through either.
Daniel.
I think I've seen bits and pieces
of
it.
Wait, what?
So I agree with you on that.
There's people who haven't seen Lady and the Tramp.
You both
and they're
homework.
Sitting here.
You must watch.
I mean, the iconic scene of them kissing. With
yeah,
the,
but it's
the,
like
yeah,
a whole thing.
So much more. There's the beaver who has to like take off the muzzle and the Siamese cats and.
I'm pretty sure I read the book when I was a kid. There was like a Disney illustrated version of it.
I'm sure there was. Yes.
Or had it read to me rather when I was like very young.
Probably one of the golden books. I have those.
Yeah.
Could be.
Yeah.
The same one. Probably the same one I had.
Probably.
Everyone had them.
Yep.
Okay.
I got plenty of them.
I still have them.
Oh, yeah.
Anyways, after that shock. I'm sorry, Pixie Dusters.
I
don't know what's wrong.
Well, I saw 101 Dalmatians. Does that count? I'm sure.
I saw that.
No,
it does, but I'm shocked.
It's two totally different movies.
No.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
Okay. Anyway,
we're gonna move on. All right. So Ben, Rattler, and Tiki, the main animals that portray Shadow, Chance, and Sassy, receive star billing in the film. But in reality, Chance and Shadow were played by 4 dogs, and Sassy was played by 10 cats.
Wow.
That blew my mind.
I would never have known that. They all look the same.
I was just what in the world is this?
Mm-hmm. It makes perfect sense with all the stuff they had to do, but in my mind, I always figured it was the same animals. I never would have guessed that it was multiple animals.
Nope. They have to, they had to have painted on the markings, because all the markings are exactly the same.
I couldn't find anything really more specific. I was trying to look up more about the animals, but they didn't really share much. Yeah. And I was curious too. I'm like, I mean, I never noticed a difference either between all of these.
I'm sure they had to paint
lots.
Them on.
They must have done something to make them all look alike. Yeah.
Especially
we also noticed. Yeah, we noticed there's a lot of shots that are like really close up too. So there's a lot of probably film trickery that can get around that.
There
too.
Is. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. With when it comes.
Yeah.
To
exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, all right. So the scene where Chance is running full throttle into a sapling and then continuing to run, specifically the part where he's calling Sassy fat when rushing off to breakfast, was done completely by accident by the dog actor. And they thought it was hilarious, so they kept it in, and Michael J. Fox and Sally Field ad-libbed the lines right after.
I meant to do that. Ah, Sarah, you're right. That's
great. Yep. And in the same vibe, Chance stumbles when he's running through a field, and he was given the line, whoa, go for a hole. So they also added that in, too. So,
that's amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh. Okay, mm-hmm. I'm going to be honest. I didn't get to rewatch these before we're doing this, but I mm-hmm. know them by heart. I've watched both of them forever, but now I'm going to have to watch. I just need to rewatch.
You pick up on more stuff now. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I need to rewatch. But, I love this movie. Mm-hmm. But it makes me cry.
It's a lovely movie. Lovely film.
I'm going to have to make Belle. Mandy's no longer with me. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to make Belle, sit next to me. And I'm just going to hold her the whole time while watching the movie. And she's going to be like, mm-hmm. what's wrong with you? Let me go.
Yeah, my dogs don't do that. They get annoyed. And I'm just like, forget it. You don't love me as much as I love you. Fine.
Raven sits on the bed.
She likes you a lot more than she likes me.
That is true.
So
Belle will let me use her as a pillow. Like, if she's laying on the couch watching the TV with me, I can lay on her and she'll be fine with it. But as soon as I grab her and pull her into my lap, she does a backflip out of my arms.
Does she actually watch TV with you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Our dogs
don't
watch TV. She
gets tired. She'll just sit there and watch the screen.
No,
yeah, our dogs don't do that.
Just nap or... look around.
She'll end up falling asleep, but she'll watch the screen with me for a little bit, and then the next thing I know, I look over and her eyes are closed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay, so some more fun trivia is about how they did things. So in the scene where Chance chases Sassy onto a seesaw and she gets catapulted through the air, obviously they had to cut everything together. So the seesaw was lifted up to a height about 4 feet and the cat was filmed on it. And then it was filmed as she was tossed from one trainer to a blanket being held by several people. And apparently the cat loved that because she purred throughout the entire thing. So I guess it was a fun thing. The cat was not traumatized at all by this. And the camera angle that was facing up, you know, that's an old trick to make it look like the height was much higher than it actually was. And then they had a fake cat that was filmed flying through the air to give the perception of distance.
That makes sense.
They have multiple fake cats, actually.
They kind of probably had to.
Yep. And then when she landed, she was dropped by a trainer from like 2 feet into the sand, which of course, So, but it's all just film trickery when they're doing all of this. Yeah. And same thing when she's in the river. So she was actually put in shallow water with a harness on her and then released by one trainer, and she swam to a second one who had a teacher's like a lead attached to her harness. And there were four people underwater to monitor her safety. There was a lot more to this, but yes, they literally talk about how they had a fake cat for part of it. Like when the guy that finds her, originally it's a fake cat that he sees, and then he goes up and they replace it with the real cat. So yeah, there's a lot going on.
That's pretty cool.
And they swapped, the cats were only in the, they kept swapping the cats out. So the cats were in the water for very brief periods of time.
Yeah, cats don't do water.
Yeah, it's a whole,
heck no.
The whole thing. Yeah. So yeah, there's a lot more to that, but I was like, it's just too much to read. But yeah, in general, that's how they did it.
But that's interesting. They were underwater, like monitoring.
Yes, yeah. So they had lots of safety people around.
So was the water not that deep?
No, it was very shallow. And during other parts, they actually had her in a pool.
Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't.
I thought like, some of that had to be a pool. Like, there's no way that could be in a river entirely.
Nope. So they basically some of it shot in a pool
and green screened around it.
Yeah. I don't know about green screen, but because I was looking at some of the close-ups of Sassy when she was like swimming, and I was watching kind of the water. I was like that. That looks like it's simulated.
Yeah, I don't even exactly. I don't think they had to do anything in the background because they just would zoom in and you wouldn't even know now she's in a pool.
Okay.
Like, I don't know how many rivers have bubbles in them because I was seeing bubbles.
Right.
Like, from the people under.
That's a freaking.
Yeah, trick. They're all just hanging out. Like, is she okay? All right. Making sure.
Well, this makes sense because 90s was big on PETA. So they probably took so many precautions to make sure that
they had lots of trainers and yeah, exactly. So to add to that, when the dogs are taken to the pound, there's a blue muzzle that's put on Shadow, but the dog had been trained to wear the muzzle, was comfortable with it, and he could actually just take it off if he wanted to.
That's cool.
So it wasn't even really, he wasn't even really muzzled at the end of the day. He could do whatever he wanted with it. And the pit really interested me to see how they filmed that. Again, I know it's all camera angles and tricks. So,
the pit. Oh, when he fell
the mud
down.
Pit. Yeah. Oh, so he's never actually. He didn't fall into a pit, right?
Really? I know, but in the movie he does, and you're like, oh.
I know it's terrible, but this is how they really did it. Okay, so when he stepped on the boards, they broke, and there was a platform right below. So then a fake dog was dropped into the pit, and then they just edited it all together. Mm-hmm. And when Shadow tries to get out, but the pit is very large and deep and muddy, and he keeps slipping back because he can't get a good grip. So to accomplish this, a special pit was dug, which was about 3 to 4 feet deep. For the sliding back and forth, one trainer was at the top of the pit calling the dog, and another was at the bottom telling the dog to stay. So when he did, he would naturally just start sliding downwards. And the dog could actually just walk out on his own, and he kept doing that while they were filming. So
that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not gonna lie. I always thought that steep was not very steep.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, no, same.
Like, you should be able to get out of this.
I think the whole point was because his leg was injured, right?
Well, yeah,
his leg was injured, and it was also really muddy too. So he's
slippery.
Around.
Yeah.
That was one of those things. Yeah, he could have gone out of it easily.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because his claws should have been able to dig into. Help him a little bit because that's what they're there for, even in mud. But
exactly,
I mean, movie, blah blah blah.
But here you go. The dog just wandered out when he wanted to when they filmed it. Yeah.
When they actually, the dogs actually went back to the owners. I'm surprised they didn't try to get him to go back to the pit to help him out.
Oh, when they first show up.
Yeah.
Yeah. No one says like starts come dragging this, them to go like, to find Shadow.
Yeah.
They all just come at the cat.
Yeah, they're just like,
Chance
we're back.
Sassy are like, yay, we're home. By the way, Shadow's like in a pit somewhere, by the way.
Let's be honest. Mm-hmm. Chance was probably so distracted. He didn't, he's a puppy. He doesn't know what to do. He's like, my person. And I'm
That's
he's
true.
Just done. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't what was it, a day?
No, it was like a couple days.
It was like a couple days?
Yeah, it was a couple days for the trek through the woods.
The whole trick?
Yeah, the whole
trip. I never thought about it.
It was a couple days.
I think it was a couple days because they had to find places to sleep and shelter and all that.
They had, sleep at night. They had the bobcat.
No. Not the movie. From when they got back to when Sassy
from the pit
got back
to when
the
they got
people,
home.
And then when Shadow shows up. It was the same day.
It was like a minute.
Yeah, it wasn't that.
They were all still outside. I mean, it was.
So they were still so. So it's not like it was multiple time periods waiting for them to go get Shadow.
But the scene prior to that, he's like, "Oh, you have to say goodbye to Chance." He was like, "Oh, that's all you have to do." Shadow was telling Chance he had to say goodbye because he was stuck in the pit. But when he got back to the house, Chance should have grabbed the owner and been like, "Hey, come find my." Shadow,
now, I got a theory on that though, because I actually thought about this for the first time watching this movie. I got a theory.
Okay.
Is that Shadow gives him this whole emotional speech, like, it's time for you to be on your own. And of course, Chance isn't having it, whatever. I want you with me. And then, the scene ends, and then the audience goes somewhere else. But see, in my mind, I like to imagine what happened when the audience isn't watching, right? Mm-hmm. So I like to imagine Chance, he has a moment. And then he says, all right, I'm on my own. Then I'm going to make a decision on my own. And this is my decision. My decision is to stay here and to help you out. Mm-hmm. And I'm not leaving until I get you out of this. Like I kind of picture that. I imagine Chance doing something.
So he knew Shadow was like right behind him then, essentially.
That's my theory. Yeah. And they helped him out. And he kind of limped along. And then maybe before Shadow just like, give me a minute, you guys go on ahead, I'll rest a minute, and then he kind of limps, that's how I picture it.
Maybe Chance went down and pushed him out, and then
That's what I always thought they should do. When Chance goes down there, I'm like, just shove his butt up there, do it,
Well, too, it's
makes
also like
you feel so much more happy inside.
Yeah. Well, it kind of makes Shadow kind of, that moment where Shadow sort of loses faith in himself, like Chance helps Shadow believe in himself again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right.
I imagine, Chance gives that whole speech and then Shadow's kind of looks up and be like, you really are a stubborn pup, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Chance's like, darn right. Mm-hmm. Let's go home. Mm-hmm. Something like that.
Right.
I like that. I wish that was a scene.
That makes sense.
Well, let me share my last trivia too. So, like you were saying, so Shadow shows up and he has a limp. So the way they did that was they put a round wooden bead between the dog's toes. It didn't hurt him, but it made it feel weird to walk. So that's why he kind of limps when he's walking. Mm-hmm. So,
wow, yeah. That's pretty cool.
Because I was like, how did they make him limp? He looks so sad, but he's not sad. He's just like, there's a.
They probably talked to a lot of dog experts and like, how would you make a. Dog limp on camera.
And I assume these people, they trainers. Probably do movie stuff all the time, so they know how to be creative and protect the pets without making it dangerous and all that. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know how old Shadow is, but there's nothing telling me.
I'm telling you, I couldn't find anything about these freaking animals. I just gave
how
up.
How old is he? So he's old and wise, but he also has a second movie, so I'm like, are you 10? Are you 9? Like, how
I mean,
old
he's
are
got
you?
The gray fur, so.
Well, that can start as early as like 5 or 6.
I know, that's what I'm saying. So he's at least maybe like 7, 8, 9. I don't know.
He has to be older than the other two.
Mm-hmm. Well, obviously.
So.
Yeah.
Well, he kept saying
Chance is probably a 1 year old?
Yeah, so maybe a year or so.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it doesn't say. This makes me angry.
I don't know.
Now I want a golden retriever. Brett is not going to be happy after this month of episodes.
You want to buy Ashley golden retriever as a wedding present?
Yep, that's it.
Brett is going to kill you.
Oh, here you go. It's moving in the box.
We brought this with us.
Don't worry, it's moving.
What's that noise?
So angry.
I just put the gifts over in this table and it just like falls off the table. Then the dog runs out.
Mm-hmm.
Runs and, like, out and runs straight for the cake.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, gosh.
As they do.
No.
And just devours the cake.
No, it is my pretty Star Wars cake. The dog cannot touch
what
it.
What kind of cake are you having?
A Star Wars cake.
What's the flavor?
He wants the flavor.
Oh, no clue. We're doing our testing next weekend.
We never did that, but that should be a good time.
But we just picked a flavor that we wanted.
You're true.
Well, we're doing a tasting to, like, she wants to do a tasting so I can show her what I want for the cake. We'll probably do chocolate. That's my favorite.
Why don't you do chocolate and vanilla?
Well, the cake itself will be chocolate. The stuff for everyone else, I don't know.
Robbie's requesting some vanilla cake.
We'll probably do a mixture, but there will be chocolate.
A mixture is great for people that do not like chocolate.
I'm not saying the whole thing's going to be chocolate, but I know there will be chocolate because I want chocolate.
That's fine.
And then I don't know what Brett wants, so we're going to see what he wants, and then if we need to do vanilla, I will tell them vanilla.
Hopefully besides chocolates, so.
Why don't you message Brett and tell him what to say?
I don't have his number.
Don't you dare.
I don't have Brett's number. Him.
I'll be like, Robbie said, please say vanilla.
Are you going to go to the bachelor party, Dan?
Oh, Dan. What?
When is the bachelor party?
I have no idea.
We're going to go all the way from Florida to Indiana.
Why are you guys inviting yourselves to a party?
Because that's what I do. No, we're going to go all the way from Florida to Indiana and not want to go to the bachelor party.
I don't know when they're doing it. They might be doing it, but like a couple weeks before the wedding.
Oh, I see.
I don't know.
All of his guys are here.
That's okay. I'll be my own best friend up there. Don't worry. I got myself.
Gosh. I've only been to one bachelor party in my life, and it was interesting.
Dan and I can just go to a movie. It's fine.
There you go.
Going to be, I think they're going to his cousin Andrew's house and shooting guns.
I see.
Chicken wings. Because they love guns.
Yeah, that's
great.
They like to blow up fruit.
Definitely not what happened at the party I went to.
Oh yeah, no, they're not. No, I will not be happy with Andrew if there are certain things there that are normal at a bachelor party.
It was Andrew.
What I went to wasn't
his best man. What, Dan?
It didn't have what you're thinking, but there were things that were. It was. I'll tell you later.
Maybe we should have this off air.
Let's put a pin in this and continue on with Homeward Bound.
It involved buying things from Spencer's. I'll just leave it at that.
Oh, okay, gotcha. We'll probably cut this part.
Yeah.
No, Sammy. We'll talk about that afterwards.
What?
She thinks I'm gonna go buy something from right now.
No. So this movie. What was my theory? What was I gonna talk about? Now I'm
brain's
on wedding.
I have no idea.
So I've always had the theory, and I think a lot of people have this theory, is that your animals end up being the same personality as the human that they're attached to. Mm-hmm. So, because I'm loud and crazy, and my dog is loud and crazy. It works. Mm-hmm. I've had friends who's had a dopey dog because, let's be honest, their owner was dopey. Mm-hmm. So, like, Jamie is annoying. I love Chance, but Chance is annoying.
Do you really think they have inner dialogues, like they did on screen? Like, oh, they're leaving, something's going on. You really, like, they're abandoning us every time we leave?
I love to believe that there is an inner dialogue of dog talk going on, and I like to try to verbalize what Belle is thinking.
What voice actor do you assign to play your dog in your mind?
Oh, my dog?
Yeah, it's a fun guy. I've thought about this a million times or before.
Oh, that's like, did you think
that's
of
a great question?
I'm thinking right now, but I'm just my Rolodex is going.
In general.
Yeah, I'm just doing actors in general. Sean Connery.
No.
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 Lucy would not be Sean Connery. No, no, no. Maybe Dexter would have been.
I don't think Sean Connery for Dexter.
No, neither do I. Okay. You're looking. She's probably doing Lucifer. I'm probably more thinking of Dexter.
Mm-hmm. Who would you be? That's a good question.
How about, do you have one, Dan?
I did. When I was growing up, my family had two dogs. We had a Maltese. He was old and he was grouchy.
Okay.
And he was in a lot, he had arthritis, so he was in a lot of pain. So in my mind, he was Hugh Laurie, aka House.
That's awesome.
Classic. Yeah,
that's awesome.
Classic.
Yeah. And then the other one was a very timid, very meek Lhasa Apso. And in my mind, he was Sam from Lord of the Rings, or Sean Astin.
That's good.
I like
that's it. Good.
Oh, such a hard question.
I know. I don't know. She's so all over the place. I don't know. Mandy was a grouchy woman, grouchy child. So I don't know what females do grouchy voices. I'm like, if I had boy dogs, it would be so much easier for me to think about. But I don't know really good voice actresses.
Mm-hmm. How about actresses in general?
Yeah, just say actors in general.
I'm thinking of that too, but I don't know. Let's see here. I gotta look some things up. Actresses.
Who would be?
List of actresses. I just need a list.
I mean, Belle is kind of a force of nature.
She is. So I'm trying to think who that force of nature would be.
Sandra Bullock.
That would be good.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. From the Speed days.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Maybe a younger Meryl Streep?
I could see that.
The death becomes her days.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. I like that.
Yeah.
Did you ever figure out Dexter?
I have not.
Let's see here. Oh, Mandy, correct me if I'm wrong, Sammy, but what if it was Jamie Lee Curtis for Mandy?
I could see that for Mandy. Yeah. I could see Mandy as Jamie Lee Curtis. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And honestly, my horse named Sammy, I could have seen her voice being Betty White.
Okay.
Cute. You love it.
Because, good. Yeah, Sammy was just, yeah, yeah.
What's Ralph and Holly's dog? What's her name?
Oh, gosh. Franny? Ooh.
Franny. When I was there, in my mind, I don't know the actress's name, but if you ever watched Animaniacs when you were a kid, you remember Slappy the Squirrel? That's
yes.
Voice for Franny. That was Franny.
That makes sense.
Oh,
that
no.
That makes sense. Oh, Franny. She's getting old.
She is.
She is. So sad. I'm trying to think. We had a ton of cats, but I just don't know. Because mm-hmm. I wasn't close to any of the cats. Yeah. Did you think of someone for Raven or Lucy?
I'm trying to decide.
That's what we're trying to decide.
Because Lucy's what? Like annoying.
He's like, well,
kind of dopey.
Feel like a good comedian.
Kind of goofy.
A good comedian would be
Does
good for him.
Does he have an older personality or a younger one?
Oh, younger.
Definitely younger.
He's a pop. He's the same age as Belle.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. So younger, kind of dopey. Yeah, that's kind of tough. Because if he was older, I would have said Jim Gaffigan. I mean, I don't know the dog, but based on what you're telling me.
No, but I love Jim Gaffigan, but I don't think it fits.
Would Robin Williams been a good voice for him? Because Robin can do dopey.
That's true. I don't know if that fits, though. That's such a just...
That's a hard question.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It makes you really.
Kevin Hart would be good.
I feel like
or,
he'd be like a
or
Kevin
Chris
Hart.
Rock.
I feel like okay. More like Kevin Hart for him.
Young and dopey actors.
Mm-hmm. Is that what you typed in? Young and dopey
literally
actors.
Literally is what I typed. Listen, everyone has.
Just because, like, I know Kevin Hart's kind of annoying sometimes.
Yeah, you're not.
You
wrong.
Know, he's got a lot of energy. He's a little guy, but with a lot of spunk. I mean, Lucifer's not super little, but, you know.
There's not a lot. He has a big personality.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Personality. And Lucy yeah. Certainly does.
There's not a lot of young male actors right now who are in that dopey area. Like
Shia LaBeouf. Shia LaBeouf in his
from the 90s.
Movies.
Yeah. From the 2000s. Yeah. Like our generation would have probably someone from our generation would have worked. Mm-hmm. What's Raven? Raven, is she more like.
She's an old lady
who's queen of the castle.
She's stuck in her ways.
Very, very cranky when she doesn't get her way or you bother her.
Would she be like a Maggie Smith?
Is Maggie Smith, is she ever cranky though? That's my question.
She is in her roles.
That's true. In her
role, she can do cranky and old. Have you seen her in what's the show? The old 20s, 1910s.
Beverly.
Family. Shoot. Now I gotta look it up. Hold on. Maggie Smith TV show. Downton Abbey. She's a cranky old lady in Downton Abbey.
Is she?
I've never seen it. She's like sophisticated cranky. It's hilarious. I've only seen a couple seasons because I love her.
Raven could be a Meryl Streep.
Older female actresses.
Oh my god, really? Look.
Jennifer Aniston.
They pulled her up when I typed in older female actress.
I guess she is.
That really upsets me.
Yep.
Oh.
Halle Berry came up too.
Hmm?
Her.
Oh, Diane Keaton.
Yeah, she could be a Diane Keaton or Sharon Stone. Your mom's no Sharon Stone. What movie is that from?
No clue.
Scream.
Why would you ask me this question?
I only saw the first Scream movie.
Yeah, when they're like, your mom's no Sharon Stone.
Oh my goodness. But yeah, I could see Diane Keaton.
I only saw it once, but it was a long time ago.
I could see her as a Diane Keaton for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because she's a little goofy too.
Or pull up Wall Street and Money Never Sleeps, the lead actress in that. Money Never Sleeps. Keep going. See all the cast.
Do we know anybody that could have been
Susan Sarandon.
Susan Sarandon.
I like Susan Sarandon. I think I like that better. What?
Do we know a dog who'd be Helena that Helena Carter, Bonham Carter could play?
Who?
That'd be entertaining. We're gonna.
I think she's just saying in general.
Oh,
just
in general.
Okay. Have somebody in mind? You have a dog in mind?
No, I don't. I was just curious.
That would be an interesting dog, though.
I feel like she would be, that would be a very, interesting dog.
Mm-hmm.
But we've gotten way off topic, so.
Yes. So there are our dog voices. And
there we go. That's
there fun. You go. Good question, Dan.
Yes, definitely good pondering.
Oh, goodness. This movie is just so iconic for any animal lover to watch.
It's the dog film, in my opinion.
It is. It is the dog film. It pulls at your heartstrings. Mm-hmm. I don't like cats in general. Like, they're okay. But I love Sassy. Like,
mm-hmm.
Great. And
she's relatable.
Yeah. And Chance, yes, he's a blumbering butt sometimes. But he's just adorable. And, Shadow.
I think I like Shadow the best.
Oh, I love Shadow.
I love Shadow.
He's like calm and chill and, you know, like somebody you can just...
The leader.
Hang out with.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to always run around.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, I agree.
I wonder if he was like that as a pup or if he was like Chance as a pup.
I mean, he probably had a lot more energy. He probably was usually, a bit more in your face when he was younger.
Who, Shadow?
Yeah.
I could see him having as a youth, he was a rambunctious youth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Not quite as dopey as Chance, but definitely in that
yes. level. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, I will say, is it me or does Peter kind of resemble Banksy?
Yes, because Robbie said, it's the same actor. He's like, it's the same kid, and I was like, no, it's a different guy. Yeah, no, you said that.
No,
yeah.
I did.
Mm-hmm. But they do. They look very similar in this movie. They do.
Obviously, Disney had a vibe. They were going for
all of it.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here. I was actually looking to see if he's still acting.
Oh, you didn't ask this time.
No, because you guys don't do that.
But I was kind of curious.
I learned my lesson.
I certainly didn't look it up at all.
Clearly.
Well, I wanted to see if he had any other stuff, and he doesn't. He's known for the Homeward Bound.
These two movies they're done.
But now he's a writer and producer.
Oh, so
he hasn't done much, but he's done some.
Okay, so he moved behind the camera.
He was a part of the editorial department for Tron Legacy.
Wow, okay, that's pretty good.
Well, that's impressive. Yeah. Okay.
And he wrote a short called Penny.
He what?
Wrote
a short called Penny. It looks like a horror movie.
Cool. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Interesting.
Yeah. Sounds like you did the smart thing. Didn't follow the child actor.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't look like his younger self.
Oh, yeah.
No.
He very much he grew into different features.
Wow.
That's good.
That doesn't look like him at all.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, good to know.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Interesting. Wait, what was that on? Don Stark. Why do I know that name? Oh, okay, I know Don Stark. Sorry. He plays in a 70s show.
Oh.
Bob. With the fro.
Uh-oh.
That thing freezing.
Hold on. Hold on.
So,
hold on.
Getting on my nerves.
There we go.
They just rebooted.
Okay.
So was it the internet or was it my Zoom?
It's you.
No, I know, but I can't figure out if it was the internet or if it was the Zoom. Because it just like froze and then it was like done.
The way you guys were frozen, you look like that famous painting from the farmer and his wife or the farmer and his daughter. You saw that very serious like.
I just sent you it. I took a picture of it and I sent it to you.
Did you? That's great. I can't wait. Oh, it's
But anyways, we need to keep moving. We're just kind of sitting on this movie.
Yeah.
Does anybody have any thoughts they want to share about this movie other than that we love it and it's amazing and it's the perfect thing ever?
I shared most of my thoughts, but I will share a funny little tidbit. As a kid, I did develop a brief irrational fear of mooses after watching this movie because of the scene where they're trying to go to sleep at night. They're like, big razor tooth. Yeah. Looking back, looking back, it's funny because like I'd be lying in bed at night, hear a slight bump somewhere in the house and be like, oh God, it's a moose in the middle of the floor.
A moose.
And he's slightly nudging kitchen chairs for no reason. As if he wouldn't just blaze through the house, right?
No, I mean, gently moving things out of his way to come get you. Just
excuse me.
The moose under your bed.
Yeah, right.
That's great.
They should be something you're scared of. If you see a moose, you want to run.
Oh yeah, no,
they're brutal. They're brutal.
They're not very scary animals.
I've heard people that live in Canada say. Yeah. Stay away from the moose.
Yes, they are
huge. I didn't realize how big they are. They're huge.
Ginormous. Yeah. Yes.
Bears, you back away slowly. Moose, you run.
Just get out of there. Mm-mm.
Get out of there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh gosh.
Oh. This is an overall family movie. You can watch it with
rated G, so yeah, anybody can watch it.
Parents, anybody, and you don't have those awkward moments. So it's a nostalgic movie that everybody should see.
Yeah.
Lovely film.
I think it still holds up to the test of time. I think this is a film that no matter how many years passed, it's like Casablanca. It's still going to hold
this
up.
This one does.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This one does.
Oh, yeah. And the next one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know, one of the things I do like is that they didn't try and do that garbage or like, let's have the pet's mouths move while they're talking.
Thank
like,
God
I
they
like
do that
they just,
oh, thank goodness.
They just do the voices and don't try and add that nonsense on top of it, you know? Yeah.
Did they do it in Cat and Dog? I think they didn't move their mouths in Cat and Dog.
Cats
and Dogs. It's another
remember.
Disney movie.
I don't know.
Do you remember Cats and Dogs?
I don't even know if I've seen it, to be honest with you.
Oh,
it's
man.
A beagle, and he gets adopted, and he wasn't supposed to be adopted, and it's to this family that's trying to create a... it's the same guy from Jurassic Park. What's his face? And he was in the glasses and the dark hair.
Oh, Jeff Goldblum?
Yes, it's Goldblum. He's a scientist in creating a cure for being allergic to dogs.
Uh-huh.
And the dogs are like in the secret agency trying to protect him from the cats who are trying to stop him. And it's so adorable.
Okay.
Apparently.
It's adorable.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen
that.
It's no Homeward Bound, but it is adorable.
Okay, yeah.
Beagle is so cute. And you hear like the inner dialogue of the dogs and the cats, and it's a mm-hmm. whole cat dog
fight. But yeah, I like that better than cool. the mouth moving and all that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Would you watch it again over
Homeward
and over?
Bound?
Yeah.
Homeward
I've
Bound?
Seen
okay,
it
yeah.
several times.
I have watched yeah. it over and over again.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean,
so.
This is another one of those movies that I recorded on a little audio cassette recorder as a kid, aww. So I could watch it over and over.
Again. It's so cute.
That's I pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I used to play this on loop. Mm-hmm. We had it on VHS.
Okay.
I don't think I had it on VHS. I think we recorded it off of like some TV, some channel. I don't think we actually owned it.
Was this a weekly movie?
Christmas or something.
This is a theater movie.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you guys remember the Friday night weekly movie on like CBS and ABC?
Vaguely.
Kind of.
Yeah. I don't think I.
Dan, do you remember that?
No,
this is before TGIF.
That was more when I started paying attention with TGIF.
Like they had a weekly yeah. movie on Fridays. No?
No. No. That's really more TGIF.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I remember TGIF. I don't remember the weekly movie.
No. Sorry.
Yeah. No, it's okay.
All right. Well,
all right.
I think that's it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, really and truly. Yeah, I don't think there's okay. much more to say. It's cute.
Yeah, no, we're good.
Mm-hmm. Well, Pixie Dusters, if for some reason you have not watched Homeward Bound yet, or you have kids who have not watched Homeward Bound yet, you really, really should. It is on Disney Plus. So go check it, right? Disney Plus? Yes?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
Go check it out. Cry with us, laugh with us, all the things.
Mm-hmm.
We will see you next week because we are going to be talking about Homeward Bound 2. Something about San Francisco. Lost.
Lost
in San Francisco. Yeah, I think.
Clearly, she's up on things.
You don't like it, but I liked it.
Listen, I had a long night.
I like the people in the next one.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So we'll get into that, yeah. Yes.
We will. So we will see you next week. Pixie Dusters, have a magical week.
Thanks for listening to the Pixie Dust Twins podcast featuring Dan. The show is written and produced by Ashley and Sammy, except for those manifestos, which are all written by Dan himself. Intro and audio editing by Sammy, logo created by Ashley. The show is produced as part of the Limitless Broadcasting Network. Make sure you check out all of our other shows and have a magical day.